If you like this video, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Check out my channel. I post a new video every day at 9. And now, today's topic, I've talked about this a couple times, but this is just going to be like a recap. This is going to be, all right, consolidated 2021. So if you want to get stronger at wrestling, all right, my number one advice is wrestling practice, all right? If you want to become a stronger wrestler, the first step is in wrestling practice, okay? It is in the practice. You and someone else on your team, you could have a clone on your team, all right? The exact same person on your team, okay? Go through the exact same practice, and one could get much better than the other just based on how hard they work, how much effort they put into every single drill that they do. All right, your coach might be telling you some drills and you're like, this is bullshit, this isn't gonna help me, whatever. I can promise you 99% of like the pointless drills that your coach makes you do, they transfer into like you know when you're doing spin drills, when your chest is on someone else's back in referee's position, all right? That spinning motion, all right, you have to get really good at that in wrestling because that happens a lot. That circling, the whole circling when your chest is on someone to like follow them, it's very, very vital. And to a lot of kids, spin drills seem pointless. But all of these very like mind-numbingly repetitive drills, right? You have to do them as hard as you can. Every single shot, like everything. The technique has to be you have to be technically sound before you're powerful and you're quick with it, all right? You have to understand exactly where like your hand goes on the neck, where your wrist is supposed to be when you're doing a half, or like, you know what I mean? You have to understand the perfect form before you work on like the speed and power, all right? So focus on your form, do the form slow, and then focus on speed and power. Speed and power, like you will only get stronger at shooting a shot by shooting a shot, all right? And by having resistance against those shots. The more resistance that you have in practice, the better. You should always aim to go with the kid that's gonna beat you up. You should always aim to go with the kid that has got the answer to your key, you know what I mean? You should always try to go with him. In my opinion, you should always try to go with the kid that just has your number, that just is a step ahead of you, that he's just like a little bit better. You should always try to challenge yourself and go with them. All right, obviously be a good teammate and beat up on other kids, but for your own sake, go with the harder opponents in practice. In practice is when you're supposed to see the most adversity that you do in your entire career. You're not supposed to like figure out at what point do you get tired in a wrestling match. You should have already known that. You should already know like how hard you can go in order to not like make yourself vomit. And you only learn that by making yourself vomit. You only learn that by pushing your body to the most absolute extremes you can during practice. Shooting as fast as you can, spinning as fast as you can, doing everything as technically perfect, as powerful, and as strong as you can every single time is the only way that you will improve. Like, you will watch yourself improve before your eyes. If you just like shut everything out of your brain, and during technique, you just focus on the technique and you try to do it as perfectly as possible. I'm talking as absolutely perfect. Okay, ignore everything your mom said, your teacher said, everything, nothing matters but the fact that you are in these four walls and that you're learning wrestling, okay? You have to learn how to control this man, all right? Do not be afraid to get tired in practice. That is what practice is for. Practice is for facing the adversity that you will face out in a tournament. And hopefully, the adversity you put yourself through is more than the adversity that other people put themselves through, okay? Obviously, do everything else. Everything else that you can do outside of practice, all right? But before you do that, step one is having a good practice, all right? If your running in the morning is hindering your practice so much that you're not learning technique, like if you got shin splints so bad that you can't shoot, or that you're having like issues with your technique, it's time to change the cardio. It's time to like let off on the cardio, focus, do one thing at a time. Do one thing at a time, build. Build from one thing to the next. I mean, you have to do this in order. You cannot be going for the fifth piece as number one. It sounds very complicated, but how I teach wrestling is it's the same way. You need to learn you have to have a perfect stance before I teach you hand fighting. You have to have Like, you have to be good at hand fighting. You have to be good at, like, hand control and head control and head position before I teach you a setup. You have to be good at setups before I teach you a shot. All right? Maybe I'm missing something. I don't know. But, like you have to do these things in order for you to, like, build and progress. And if you've been doing them out of order, you have to start from block one. To start from block one, do it the hard way. Spend the hours, spend the days, spend the weeks doing it the hard way. Okay? Like, I've learned that the simple hard way is always, like, that is the usually the path of least resistance, like, in order to win, okay? Other than taking steroids or some shit that, like, I'm against, I don't see any other way to improve quicker than your opponents in the same 24 hours. Like, if you're a real beginner and you focus more on running before practice than you do actual practice, like, this is gonna affect you, or, like, whatever it is, if it's powerlifting, if it's kettlebell, like, whatever it is, like, it, like, in the right context, everything is helpful, and in the right context, everything will be detrimental to you, okay? Thing that you need to focus on is, like, if you're still getting sore from a hard wrestling practice, like, if you get physically, like, sore, like, that's an issue. That's a real issue that you need to, like, you need to be doing hard, like, wrestling as hard as you can, every single day, to a point where, like, it's just normal. Like, your body just does it. You know what I mean? Your body just handles it. Obviously, lifting weights and, like, kettlebells and stuff will make you more powerful and strong. But the number one easiest way to get stronger in wrestling is just going harder in practice. Going way, way harder. Like I'm talking turn every single knob to 100. Like, intelligence, agility, speed, like, everything up to 100. So if you guys like that video, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Check out my channel. I post a new video every day at 9. I'm gonna start live streaming after these videos, so stay tuned for that. I'm gonna buy a monitor either today or tomorrow, and I'm gonna do live match reviews. I'm gonna have live match reviews. I'm really excited for that. Tell me, do you guys want it on Twitch or do you want it on YouTube? Like, which one would you rather prefer? Because, like, I don't think I have the bandwidth to do both. I don't know. I'll figure it out. I gotta get a monitor first. But until next time, I'll see you guys. Peace.